ಗೋಪಿಜನ ಜಗಿರೆ ಯಶೋದಾನಂದನ ವ್ರಜ ಜನರಂಜನ ಜಮುನಾ ತೀರ ಜಯ ಜಯ ರಾಧಾ ಮಾಧವ ಜಯ ಕುಂಜ ವಿಹಾರ ಜಯ ಗೋಪಿ ಜನ ವಲ್ಲಭ ಜಗಿರಿ ಯಶೋದಾನಂದನ ವ್ರಜ ಜನರಂಜನ ಜಮುನಾ ತೀರ ಜಯ ಜಯ ರಾಧಾ ಮಾಧವ ಹರೆ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೆ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೆ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೆ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೆ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೆ 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 ರಾಮ ಹರೆ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೆ 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 Radha Gopinath Radha Gopinath Radhe Radhe Jai Jai Radha Gopinath Radha Gopinath Radhe Radhe Hari Bol Hari Bol Hari Bol Hari Bol Hari Bol Jayo Jaya Prabhupada 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 Jaya Prabhupada जयो विश्वपाद परमहंस परिवजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शतस्य श्रीमती देवान ग्रेस येसे भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। जयो विश्वपाद परमहंस परिवजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शतस्य श्रीमती देवान ग्रेस भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी महाराज श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वंद की जय। नामाचार्य श्री हरिदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासति गौर भक्त वृंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन की जय। ब्रजभूमि श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय। नवद्वीप मायापुर धाम की जय। पुरुषोत्तम क्षेत्र श्री जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की जय। गंगा मैया जमुना मैया की जय। भक्ति देवी श्री तुलसी महारानी की जय। निताई गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवतीरुत्तम श्लोके भक्ति भवते नैष्टिके। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामिनि गौर तुषे नमः वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद
हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
श्री राधा गोपीनाथ भगवान की जय हरे कृष्ण टुडे वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 11, chapter number 27, text number 8. Yada Swanigame Noktam Dvijatvam Prapya Purushaha यथा यजत मां भक्त्या श्रद्धया तानि बोध मे यदा स्वानिगम्य उक्तम द्विजत्वं प्राप्य पुरुषः यथा यजत मां भक्त्या श्रद्धया तानि बोध मे यदा स्वानिगमे नोक्तम् द्विजत्वं प्राप्य पुरुषः यथा यजेत मां भक्त्या श्रद्धया तानि बोध मे
Thank you.
माता जी इस Translation and purport by the disciples of His Divine Grace, Sri Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj Srila Prabhupada. Translation. Now please listen faithfully as I explain exactly how a person who has achieved twice born status through the relevant Vedic prescriptions should worship me with devotion. Purport. The word Swanigamena refers to the particular Vedic injunctions relevant to one's social occupational status. Member of the Brahma Kshatriya and Vaishya communities, Brahmana, Kshatriya and Vaishya communities, all achieve Dvijatvama, twice born status, by initiation into Gayatri Mantra. Traditionally, fully qualified Brahmana boys may be initiated at age of 8, Kshatriya at 11, and Vaishya at 12, provided the proper conditions are met. Having achieved twice born status, one should faithfully worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead in His form of deity, as the Lord Himself will describe. Om Agyanatim Andasya Gananjana Shalakya Chakshur Inmiltham Yanatasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimade Bhaktivedanta Swamiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharini Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Prashyata Deshatarini Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Shivasati Gaurav Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare Hare Krishna. So today, according to Vaishnava calendar, Vaishnava Tithi, today is the Mahashivaratri. Of course, most of the people celebrated yesterday, but somehow our calendar is a little different. Huh? Today is Mahashivaratri.
Outside, they celebrate it on Magh Krishna Trayodashi, which is Pradosh. But in Hari Bhakti Vilas, for Gaudiya Vaishnavas, it is Magh Krishna Chaturdashi, which is Shivaratri. So today, it will always be next day.
Jai
Ho, it is not a mistake or rare occurring.
So we have an authority here. Radha Diti Prabhu. Sanatana Goswami. So we are celebrating Mahashivaratri. So we'll try to discuss a little bit the glories of Lord Shiva. Mahashivaratri is one of the most famous celebration all over India. And most of the people, they have right intention of celebrating Mahashivaratri. But there are some people who try to take a disadvantage of Mahashivaratri. Many people, they say, bam bam bhole. Bam bam bhole means they smoke weed, ganja. They also drink liquor in the name of Shiva, Shivaratri. And if you ask them, why are you doing this? This even Shiva is doing. Shiva is smoking ganja, he is smoking weeds, he is drinking liquor. So we are also doing the same thing. But actually it's not true. Nowhere in the scriptures, you don't find any scriptural evidence that Shiva is smoking ganja or bhang or he is drinking liquor. You'll never find it. Of course, most of the people know this is wrong. But still some people they want, because the influence of Kali Yuga. And I found there are many YouTube videos, there are videos also in YouTube, very famous videos. People try to give explanation how smoking ganja is good for health. Once in a week you should smoke. And people say, oh yes, good. Actually there is no need to give some mundane explanations. There are, if you want to do intoxication, it's okay. But nowhere in the scripture is found that Shiva is smoking. Ha, we should not misunderstand that in heavenly planet, Indra and other gods, they drink somras. But that somras is not compared to our wine and drink liquor here. Even if they smoke something in heavenly planets, those medicinal herbs, that somra rasa, is completely different from the liquor and wine we find in this world. And what to speak of even a heavenly planet? Here in this world, on this earth planet, there are different varieties of wine and liquors. There are best brand of wines like Gallo, Yellowtail, and there are lowest brand. The example is Ginefandel or Melor. I asked the Google Prabhu, they told me this. What is the best brand of liquor and what is the lowest brand? So if you find the difference between these two, it's like, you know, vast difference. You cannot even compare earthly wine or liquor. What to speak of heavenly? Shiva is intoxicated. He's totally maddened, but not by drinking liquor or smoking ganja. He's totally drunk, he's totally maddened in Krishna Prema. Chaitanya Charitamrita explains, Krishna Prema Unmatta Vivala Digambara Guna Krishna Guna Lila Gaye Nache Nirantara. Lord Shiva, he's always in ecstasy singing the glories of Lord Krishna. So there are no evidences we find where Shiva is drinking liquor or smoking ganja. And even if he drinks some heavenly beverages, but still we cannot imitate him. Like Shiva, he drank poison during the churning of the ocean. The first thing which came out of the ocean was halal vish, that Kalakut poison. Shiva drank that poison. Can we imitate Shiva? Because Shiva drank the poison. So if you want to drink some liquor or smoke ganja, so we should also imitate Shiva by drinking some quantity of poison. It's not possible. Prabhupada writes that sun god drinks urine. Sometimes people pass urine on the road. So sun god, through its sun rays, absorbs that urine. But sun never becomes contaminated. So all these great personalities who are transcendental, their activities cannot be imitated. We can learn from their teachings. In India, this trinity, Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh, they are very famous. Everyone practically in India, everyone knows Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. But there is also another concept. There is always debate. Who is supreme? Whether the Brahma is supreme, Shiva is supreme, or Vishnu is supreme. And especially between these two, Shiva and Vishnu. When Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was in Kanchipuram, he went to take darshan of Shiva. And he found there was a hot debate going on between the Vaishnavas and the Shaivites. Who is supreme? So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was asked. Mahaprabhu Chaitanya simply laughed. He said, these people are immature. They don't understand who Shiva is. Most of the people, they don't read scriptures. What is the position of Shiva? What is the position of Shiva? What is the Vishnu? And what is the position of Brahma? It's already mentioned in the scriptures. But sometimes it is even confusing, even while reading scriptures also. There are many Puranas and scriptures which are meant for the people who are in the mode of ignorance. Some Puranas and scriptures are meant for the people who are in the mode of passion, and some for the mode of goodness. And there is a particular method of worship recommended for a person who is in a mode of ignorance,
and also passion. So if you read the Puranas which are in the mode of passion and ignorance, the demigods, they are also glorified as the supreme. So why sometimes Durga is glorified as supreme, sometimes Shiva is worshipped, glorified as the supreme, or Brahma is glorified as supreme? Because the worshipper should have full faith in them, otherwise they will not worship. So if a person is in the mode of goodness or ignorance and passion, he wants to appraise his consciousness, then he has to have full faith in the deity. One time Srila Prabhupada was in Chennai, and one worshipper of Shiva, he came and he started discussing with Prabhupada. He said, "Swamiji, yesterday I met your disciple Giriraj, and I was arguing with him. He also argued. I was saying that Shiva is supreme, and your disciple Giriraj was saying that Krishna is supreme. What is your opinion?" But Krishna, Prabhupada didn't enter into the hard argument. He said, in Sanskrit there are two words. One is puja and other is bhakti. Puja means those who worship demigods, while worshipping demigods, they have some alternative motive. They want some material benedictions from their Lord. But bhakti means it is purely done only for the pleasure of Krishna. So then this worshipper of Shiva asked, "Is it possible to worship Shiva without any motivation, with a pure devotion?" Then Prabhupada said, "Yeah, it is possible. It's very rare. It's exceptional." And then Prabhupada gave an example. Just like if you find a person entering into wine shop, what do you expect? Generally, whenever a person enters into wine shop, that means he wants to drink liquor. There are very, very rarely some people, they will go to wine shop and they say, "I just want one glass of water." Generally, for drinking water, they don't go to the wine shop. But there are some exceptional cases. Similarly, worshipping demigods means with some material desires. And this person was happy with the explanation. And then another time, Mr. Malhotra ji, he was talking with Prabhupada, and suddenly the discussion came into, "Now, who is supreme?" So then Malhotra ji asked Prabhupada, "Prabhupada, who is supreme, Shiva or Krishna?" Then Prabhupada said, "Only immature people will discuss this thing, who is supreme, whether Shiva or Vishnu. We all are debating amongst ourselves who is supreme, and those two, Shiva and Vishnu or Krishna, they are competing with each other. Who will serve the other best? Shiva wants to serve Krishna and Krishna wants to serve Shiva." Like for example, Vrikasur. When Vrikasur, he was performing some tapasya, he created a fire yajna, and he started cutting off his own bodily limbs and putting into the fire. Finally, after 6 days, he saw Shiva is not appearing. So he was ready to chop off his head and put him into the fire. Shiva had to come. And Prabhupada writes that demigods are obliged. They are bound to give benedictions to their worshippers. But Krishna is not. Krishna, if Vrikasura wants, Krishna will say, "At the first day only you can cut off your head, no problem. I am not bound to give benedictions to you." And then Prabhupada says, this is the difference. All the demigods, they are bound to give benedictions to their worshippers. But Shiva, Krishna is not. In the reciprocation, Shiva also, he wants to glorify Krishna. So when Krishna appeared as a Mohini avatar, Shiva ran behind Mohini. Actually, he was not influenced by the beauty of Mohini, but he wanted to glorify Krishna as the supreme, that how I am subordinate to Lord Krishna. Then Malhotra ji asked, "But Prabhupada in Rameshwaram, Lord Ramchandra personally worshipped Shivalinga. So what is your opinion about that?" Prabhupada said, that is out of pure love for his devotee. Shiva is Krishna's devotee, so he wants to give some, he wants to worship his devotee. And Prabhupada said, it's not out of fear. It's not that Krishna or Lord Ram is asking permission to kill Ravana, because Ravana is a devotee of Shiva, and therefore Ram is asking permission. No, it's not for asking permission. It is purely devotion, or he wants to worship his devotee. And then Prabhupada gave example of Sudama. When Sudama came to Dwarka, Krishna personally washed his feet. So that doesn't mean that Sudama has become greater than Krishna. So similarly, when Krishna, Ram, worships Ravana, worships Shiva, that is a reciprocation, loving reciprocation between these two. Even in the Bhrigu's Leela, when the demigods, they appointed Bhrigu Muni to find out who is the supreme, whether Brahma, Shiva or Vishnu. So Bhrigu Rishi first went to Brahma planet and he saw Brahmaji was sitting with Parvati. So Bhrigu Rishi, he offended Brahmaji mentally. He did not offer obeisances to Brahmaji, because Brahmaji is the father, but he did not offer obeisances to him. He committed an offense mentally, but Brahmaji became angry. Then Bhrigu Muni went to Kailash, where Shiva was sitting with Parvati. And then Bhrigu Rishi, he offended Shiva by speaking some ill words, bad words to him. Shiva became very angry. Finally, Bhrigu Rishi went to Svetadipa, where Lord Vishnu was lying on Ananta Shesha. Lakshmi was massaging his feet. At this time, Bhrigu, neither mentally nor verbally, he directly kicked him on his chest. Physically, he committed offenses towards Vishnu. But in response, Lord Vishnu got up and he said, "My dear Bhrigu Rishi, your feet are so soft, my chest is so hard." And he started massaging the feet of Bhrigu Rishi. So Bhrigu Rishi said, "My God, who is this person?" So finally, it was proved that Krishna is supreme, Vishnu is supreme. But Chaitanya Bhagavat explains, Shiva, he knew that Bhrigu is testing everyone. And therefore, purposefully, Shiva became angry. Vrindavan Das Thakur writes in Chaitanya Bhagavat, purposefully Shiva became angry because he wanted to show that this is my Lord Krishna, Vishnu will be glorified. So let me become angry. Let me take the subordinate position. So what is Shiva's role? Very beautiful. Shiva has then accepted the thankless task. Those people who are having no capacity to worship directly Lord Shiva or Lord Krishna, because Krishna's worship demands a lot of surrender, purity, rules, regulations. Such beings like ghostly beings, hobgoblins, demons, they are not qualified to worship Krishna. So such souls, they take shelter of Shiva. So Krishna has given that service to Shiva, that you take care of these people. And Shiva, when someone worships Lord Shiva throughout their life, at the end of their life, at the time of death, Shiva personally chants Lord Rama's name in the ear of his worshipper. And especially at Varanasi, Kashi, he does that. And when Shiva finds that someone is very sincere and genuine, he sends such a person in the same lifetime in the association of his devotees, like Krishna's devotees. There was one poor Brahmana, he was in need of some money, but he was very sincere, genuine. So Shiva told him, in Vrindavan, at Dwadash Adish Tila, there is one sadhu, his name is Sanatana Goswami. he has a lot of wealth. You go and approach him. So this Brahmana came to Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana Goswami was chanting Hare Krishna mantra. And this Brahmana said, my dear sir, Shivji has sent me to you, that you have some wealth. Sanatana Goswami said, yes, I have a touchstone. It is lying in the garbage pit. I have dumped it in the garbage pit. Please go and take it from there. So he went and he saw the touchstone was there in the garbage pit. He picked up the touchstone, but because he was intelligent, he was thinking in his mind, if this person is throwing this touchstone in the garbage, that means this touchstone is not valuable for him. There is something more valuable with him. Let me ask him. So then he went and asked Sanatana Goswami, my dear sir, do you have more valuable than this touchstone? He said, yes. First of all, you throw this touchstone, then I'll give you that highest one. And then Sanatana Goswami said, now you sit here and chant Hare Krishna with me. Because we are conditioned soul, at this moment we may not understand the value of Hare Krishna mantra. Every day we are chanting Hare Krishna mantra, but can we understand that, you know, this chanting Hare Krishna mantra is million times more valuable than touchstone? But when we become completely pure, reach to that level, then we will also understand one day that chanting Hare Krishna is the only reality. So when Shiva becomes very, very merciful, he finds someone sincere and genuine, he sends his to Krishna's devotees. So absolutely there is no difference between Shiva and Vishnu, but there is one slight difference. Brahma Samhita explains, Kshiram yatha dadi vikara vishesha yogat. Vishnu is like a milk and Shiva is like a curd. There is slight vikar, but that vikar is very vishesha. And what is that vishesha vikar? Chaitanya Charitamrita explains, dugda ena amla yoge dadi rupa dhare dugdantara vastu nahe dugda haite nare. When a milk, if you add some sour elements in the milk, it turns into curd. Now it is no more milk. Milk is the beginning. After adding some sour elements, it becomes curd. That properties is totally changed. Although it's more milk product, but still there is still difference. So milk and curd. So this is the difference between Shiva and Vishnu. Then his next says, Maya Sangha Vikari Rudra Bhinna Bhinna Rupa Jiva Tattva Haye Nahe Krishna Raswarupa. Krishna, he is about three modes. Lord Shiva is in charge of ignorance, mode of ignorance, but he is not ignorant. Although he is in charge of the mode of ignorance, but he is not ignorant. Prabhupada writes, just like a jailer, he is in charge of the prison house, but he is not like other prisoners. He is beyond the rules of prison house. Shiva Maya Shakti Sanghi Tamo Guna Kesha Maya Tita Guna Tita Vishnu Paramesha. So the difference between Vishnu and Krishna is, Vishnu has no touch with the material energy, and Shiva is having an intimate touch with the material energy. That is the only difference. Then Prabhupada writes that Krishna has 64 qualities, Vishnu has 60, Shiva has 55, and those jivas who have perfected their life, headed by Brahma, they have at the most 50 qualities. So in this way, there are gradations in the Vedic society. Shiva, his service to Krishna is very unique. This point is very beautiful. Just like Lord Nityananda Prabhu, when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was in Jagannath Puri, there were some devotees of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they were staying with Mahaprabhu in Jagannath Puri. Nityananda Prabhu also wanted to stay with him. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Nityananda, you go to Bengal and preach all over Bengal. He was not allowed to stay with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Similarly, Shiva is also not allowed to stay with Krishna. Krishna says, Krishna orders Shiva that is my request, is my order, that you please take care of these ghostly beings, those who have no chance of deliverance or liberation. Shiva accepts this thankless task. Now, who will want to associate with the ghostly beings? Even sadhus are afraid of ghosts, right? When we hear even the hearing stories of ghostly beings, it is afraid, right? We become fearful. So, Shiva constantly, he is only with the ghostly beings and hobgoblins and demons. He is surrounded by all such living entities. But because what can he do? It is the instruction of Krishna. So he is accepting Krishna's instructions and therefore he is staying with all these ghostly beings. When Nityananda Prabhu is feeling separation from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is totally in a maddened situation. He is like an avadhut. He doesn't even understand where he is going, where the Bangla, the pathway of Bengal. He just forgets everything. So similarly, Shiva, he also forgets everything. He smears ashes all over his body and therefore is called Bhasma Bhuta. He wears the garland of skulls and therefore is called Kapali. He holds the trident and the damru in his hand and therefore he is called Shulapani. He has a long matted hair and therefore is called Jatadhari. He is always surrounded by ghostly beings, therefore he is called Bhutnath. He always travels in the night time, therefore he is called Nishachara. He is the lord of terror, therefore he is called Bhairava. And he has a third eye. Everyone has generally two eyes. Lord Shiva has a third eye. One time Parvati Mai, very lovingly, she covered eyes of Shiva with her hands. And then she found that the whole universe became dark. The whole universe was enveloped by darkness. So Shiva miraculously suddenly opened his third eye to illuminate the whole universe with heat and light. So this third eye, Krishna, Shiva has, therefore is called Trilochana. And his ornaments are snakes, armlet snakes, anklets, and all these ornaments are made up of snakes. Therefore, it is called Nagabhushana. And his roaring is so fearful. Therefore, it is called Rudra. And because he is such an avadhut, in Krishna Prem, he is dancing. He doesn't even understand whether he is wearing clothes or not. Therefore, his name is called Digambara. His another name is Shankara because he bestows auspiciousness, happiness on everyone. His also another name is Gangadhar. He holds Ganga in his jata. When he saw Bhagiratha brought Ganga from the heavenly planet, not heavenly planet, from the spiritual world. So Shiva, he told everyone that if Ganga directly falls on the earth planet, the earth will burst into pieces. So better I should hold this first in my head. Actually, the inner reason was, he wanted to take the Charanamrita of Lord Krishna first on his head and then he wanted to give Ganga to everyone. So therefore he is called Gangadhar. He is the best dancer, therefore he is called Nataraj. So when he is in so much of ecstasy, he is so detached. He doesn't keep any material opulences with him. When he got married to Parvati, Parvati Mai saw there was nothing, there is only mountain, Kailash Mount. So then she said, my dear husband, now we are married, we are a grahasthas. At least we should have some house. Shiva said, okay. So he built a small cottage. No furniture, nothing. He had nothing. So when during his marriage, all the sages and rishis, they came for asking charity. So he started giving everything. So finally one last sage came and he said, my dear sir, please give me something. Shiva had nothing. So he even gave that home also charity. So finally he had a small cottage. That also he has donated as a charity. So he is aniketa. He doesn't even have home. And other meaning is, he wants to show to his all worshippers and followers that all these material opulences, they are temporary and illusory. Therefore, we should not be attached to these things. Of course, to become detached from this material opulence, one should be completely attached to Krishna, that Shiva wants to show. And there are many qualities explained in the Bhagavatam also, Lord Shiva's qualities. The first is Dhira Purusha. He is very sober, very Dhira Purusha. When Chitraketu Maharaj, Shiva was giving Bhagavatam class, Narada and sages and rishis, they were sitting and hearing Bhagavatam class from Shiva, and his wife Parvati was sitting on his lap, and he was speaking on Vairagya, renunciation. And Chitraketu was flying in the airplane, in the air, and he saw Shiva is so great. He's speaking on principles of renunciation, Vairagya, and his wife is sitting on his lap, such a great person, but he spoke in a different way, like a sarcastic way. So then Shiva didn't bother. Shiva didn't bother, you know, what he was saying. But Parvati became very angry. Of course, she became angry because she couldn't tolerate the insult of her husband. So therefore she cursed Chitraketu Maharaj. But Shiva glorified Chitraketu Maharaj. So this shows he's such a dhira purusha. And he's completely detached from name, fame and prestige. Daksha, he had arranged one of the biggest yajna sacrifice at his place. He had invited all the demigods except Shiva. And Shiva is a son-in-law of Daksha. So can you imagine the position of Shiva? Who will reject his own son-in-law? But Daksha didn't invite Shiva. But Shiva did not bother. He said, so what? If he didn't call me, he didn't invite me for yajna, no problem. But Sati felt, no, I should go. So he is completely detached from name, fame and prestige. He is very, very merciful. He is merciful even to bhutas and hobgoblins and ghostly beings. He always travels with these beings who have no material bodies. And whenever he finds someone is indulged in illicit sex, immediately he places those ghostly beings into their womb. Or those people who are having a relationship at an improper time, even such place also, Shivji, he places those ghostly beings in their life. So Shiva, he offers the bodies, material bodies, physical bodies, even to the ghostly beings. Rupa Goswami, he writes, Srimad Gopishwaram Vande Shankaram Karunamayam Sarva Klesham Haram Devam Vrindaranya Ratim Pradam. Shiva is not just a remover of klesha or suffering. He is also Rati Pradanam. He offers Krishna prema or attachment or love for Vrindavan Dham. Gopeshwar Mahadev, Lord Shiva, he is fed up with all this association of ghostly beings. So he approached Vrinda Devi and said, my dear Devi, please allow me to enter into the Rasa Leela. She said, but you are in the body of a male, Purusha, you are not allowed. He said, please do something. She said, okay, no problem. You take bath in Mansarovar. So Shiva takes bath in Mansarovar. He becomes female, he becomes a gopi. And Vishwanatha Thakur writes that Yamuna river, she personally arranged the clothing, gopi cloths and ornaments and jewelry for Lord Shiva. So Shiva wears all that ornaments and dress, and then he partakes in a Rasa Leela. And then Shiva becomes completely happy. He got some relief from his service of being with the ghostly beings. His main services are, actually he wants to serve all the devotees of Krishna. And therefore he requested Krishna, that my dear Krishna, please give me a chance to serve in Vrindavan Dham. Please make me a mountain. So he expanded as a Nandeshwar in Nandagaon. And all that Nandagaon village is founded on Gopeshwar Mahadev. He is a Dham Rakshak. He becomes a Chakleshwar Mahadev. He expands as Chakleshwar Mahadev at Govardhan. He becomes a Nandeshwar Mahadev at Nandagaon. He is a Bhuteshwar Mahadev in Mathura and Kameshwar Mahadev in Kamyavan. He also wanted to render some service to Sanatana Goswami. When Sanatana Goswami was writing some literature at Manasi Ganga, some mosquitoes were biting him. So Sanatana Goswami thought, okay, let me leave this place. So he decided to leave Manasi Ganga. But Shiva, he said, my dear sir, please, I want your association. You stay with me here at Manasi Sarovar, Manasi Ganga. And some other, he called the in charge of the mosquito, the demigod. He said, from tomorrow onwards, there should not be one single mosquito roaming here. So he made that arrangement, and then Sanatana Goswami continued to stay at Manasi Ganga. He also, Chaitanya Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes, at Rudra Dweep, Shiva personally told Bhaktivinoda Thakur his Swarupa, that you are Kamal Manjari, Kamal Gopi in the spiritual world. Not only Shiva, all his family, his wife, Parvati, sons, Shiva, Ganesh, Kartikeya, they are also fully involved and engaged in Krishna's service. Parvati Maya, she is a yoga maya. She appears as younger sister of Krishna. She also performs many leelas with Krishna. There is one leela during, on the Govardhan Parikrama, there is one temple of Gauri. Every day, Sri Radha goes to worship Gauri. And one day, Jatila, mother-in-law of Radha, she comes to know that Radharani went to meet Krishna at Gauri temple. So she also hurriedly comes over there. She wants to catch Radha and Krishna are there. So when Krishna comes to know that she is here, Jatila is here, Krishna enters in the deity of Gauri. And now Gauri is speaking to Jatila. Oh Jatila, if you leave this Mathura, sorry, if you leave the Vrindavan and go to Mathura, as soon as you reach Mathura, your son Abhimanyu will die. Because they were planning to shift from Vrindavan to Mathura. So then she says, no, my Devi, please bless us. And then Gauri says, okay, you stay here and let your daughter-in-law come every day to worship me. So in this way, Parvati Mai, she serves very intimately to Krishna and all his devotees. Even Ganesha, there is one temple of Ganesha on the border of Mathura and Vrindavan. He is called Vignesha. So the gopis, they used to worship this Vignesha to remove all the obstacles from their path. They want to meet every day Krishna, but every day there are some obstacles. They want to remove those obstacles by worshipping Ganesha. So therefore, although this family, Shiva's family, they are intimately involved in Krishna's service, but without taking the credits. Because neither Vaishnavas nor Shaivites, they give a direct credit to Shiva. You will find even Ganesha, he is present in all the major temples of Goswamis in Vrindavan. At the entrance, here also you will find Ganesha. He is without taking any credit, he is simply just removing the obstacles of the devotees and he wants the blessings of the Vaishnavas. So, Ganesha, he also released that ecstasy of Krishna Prema. When Shiva, he is in a Rasalila with Krishna, he is playing his Damru. And Ganesha also, small Ganesha, he also accompanies his father. He also dances in that Rasa Leela. Of course, there are many beautiful pastimes. I'll cut my lecture short. Shiva also serves as Acharya. He started his Sampradaya, Rudra Sampradaya, one of the four main Sampradayas, Rudra Sampradaya. Because Lord Shiva's family is totally engaged in Krishna's service, therefore there is no quarrel or any arguments in his family. If you see the family members of Shiva, Shiva's carrier is bull, and Parvati, Durga's carrier is lion. So lion and bull, they don't get along. They don't have friendship. Lion eats bull. And Kartikeya's carrier is peacock. And Ganesha's carrier is mouse. And peacocks eat mouse. But here in this family, you will find the peacock, the mouse, the bull and a lion. They're all staying, and also snake. Of course, Shiva, around his neck, there is a snake. So peacock is always looking at the snake, but he knows now the snake has taken shelter of Shiva. So although all his enmity is there, but still because everyone is engaged in Krishna's service, therefore, they're all happily staying with no quarrels. So this is the secret. If you want to stay happy in family life, in worldly life, we have to keep ourselves fully busy in Krishna's service. Last one story I want to tell about from Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastime. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was a small Nimai. He was very naughty. Every day he would go to Mother Ganga to take bath and play. Sometimes he would see some young girls. They came with a big paraphernalia, puja paraphernalia. They would bring sweet dishes, fruits and flowers to worship Shiva, to get nice husband in their life. So, as a naughty boy, Nimai, he would go and snatch away all the sweet dishes from there. And he would say, Kannara kahe ama puja, ami dibavara, Ganga Durga dasi mora, Mahesha kinkara. He would say that all these sweet preparations and fruits and flowers, give it to me, offer it to me, I will give you benedictions. Because Ganga and Parvati and Durga, they are all my dasis, they are my maid servants. And Mahesha is my kinkar. Shiva is my das. So the girls would become afraid. But then he would say, if you don't offer it to me, I will curse you. So then they would give everything to Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and then Mahaprabhu would give them benedictions and blessings. Let each one of you have beautiful, handsome, very healthy, wealthy husband, and he will have 7 sons. And then all the young girls, they would become very happy. So in this way, Prabhupada writes, actually there is no need to worship demigods for a devotee, but just like gopis, they used to worship Katyayani, they used to worship Ganesha, they also used to worship Gopeshwar Mahadev, but only for one purpose. They wanted to increase their love for Krishna. They wanted to increase their dedication for Krishna. And therefore, this was the only purpose of worshipping any demigods. So Vaishnavas, they never hate anyone. They offer respect and worship to everyone. But their goal is very clear. They simply want to serve Krishna. So why all these, although Shiva and other demigods, they are the most prominent demigods, but you don't find them on the altar? Because their services are different. They are selling the different products. So these Gaudiya Acharyas, they are directly given an instruction and order of giving and serving or distributing Krishna Prema. But Shiva's service is different, other demigods different service. So therefore, we have respect and we worship every demigods, but our goal is clear that we want love for Krishna. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.